Solution of quadratic equations by factorization is an excellent technique to solve trinomial equations with integral coefficients. Here we are given a question which we are going to solve by applying this technique for solution of quadratic equations. The procedure for this type of solution is written here on the right hand side. And as step one of the procedure, we are going to find out values of A, B, and C by comparing this equation with quadratic equation in general form. So let's get started. The given equation is, at 9x squared minus 6x minus 8 equal to 0, and let's call this as equation number 1, and we will compare it with the quadratic equation in general form, comparing with general form or with general quadratic equation. And what is the general form of the quadratic equation? That is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. And for sure, a cannot be equal to 0. If a is equal to 0, then it becomes a linear equation. So for quadratic equation, a cannot be equal to 0. And let's name this as equation number 2. When we compare both equation 1 and 2, what we see is the coefficient of x square in equation 2 is a, and coefficient of x square in equation 1, I mean the given equation, is 9. Therefore, we can find, or we can say that the value of a in general terms is equal to 9. And b, the coefficient of x, by comparing, we can write equal to minus 6, and the constant term c is equal to minus 8. So this was our first step of the procedure. Now, once we have a, b, and c, step 2 would be to find out the value for ac. Step 2 is find values for ac. Find value of AC. And AC means the product of the value of A and C, which is equal to 9 times minus 8. That is equal to minus 72. And as our procedure clearly tells us that if the value of the product AC is negative, then we are interested in finding two such factors of 72 whose difference is equal to b without algebraic sign of b, means 6. So obviously we will find factors of 72, and then we will see which of the two factors are for our interest. So let's find out factors of 72. We can find factors of 72 by using two different techniques. Generally, this is technique we use is that we find linear factors starting with the prime numbers on the left side with 2 times 36, and 36 is not a prime while 2 is a prime, so we discontinue further factorizing 2, but we continue with 36, which is again 2 times 18. And we discontinue with 2, but we continue with 18, which is 2 times 9. We discontinue with 2, but we continue with 9 because 9 is not a prime number. But this time 2 is not a factor, so we break down 9 into 2 factors, 3 times 3, which are both prime numbers. Therefore, 72 is equal to 2 times 2 times 2 times 3 times 3. This process is called linear factorization of 72. We have another technique as well. We can use that technique called small division, and we generally write down the first few prime numbers 2, 3, 5, 7 and so on. And if the given number is even, we start dividing by 2 and we get 36. Again, 36 is a even number. We can divide further by 2 and 18. 18 is further divisible by 2. This will give us 9 and this will give us 3 times 3 and 3 times 1 is equal to 3. And whichever way, you can see that the linear factorization of 72 is same. It's 2 times 2 times 2 times 3 times 3. So whichever way you do the linear factorization, you will reach at the same factors. Now we are interested in finding two such factors of 72 whose difference is equal to 6. Because if the product AC is negative, we only are interested in finding the two such factor whose difference is equal to value of B without considering sine of B. And we know that 72 is equal to 1 times 72, but that's not what we are looking for, because 72 minus 1 is equal to 71. We don't need this. And 9 times 8 is also 72, but we don't need this. Here, if we take a look on 12 times 6, these are factors of 72 and their difference is equal to 6. So we are going to take these numbers 12 and 6 and apply these numbers for our step number 3. For step 3, what we need is we simply copy our equation. And what was the equation? The equation was x square, 9x square. 9x square minus 6x minus 8 equal to 0. This was the 9x square minus 6x minus 8 is equal to 0. And we don't change anything in this equation other than simply rewriting the value of 6. So here you can see that I'm writing 9x square as 9x square, then negative sign. And instead of 6, we are going to write 12 minus 6, because 12 minus 6 is again equal to 6. So x and then minus 8 and then equal to 0. See, we haven't changed anything other than simply writing 6 equal to difference of those two factors of 72. Now, what this will do for us, this will change the equation from 3 terms to 4 terms. See here, 9x square minus, and now if we multiply, it's a distributive property of real numbers. If we multiply x inside, this will give us minus 12x plus 6x and then minus 8 equal to 0. And now we can see that we have 4 terms. So we can regroup, and for regrouping we take common from the first two terms, which is 3x, and inside we have 3x minus 4, and from the last two terms we can take common 2, and if we take 2 common, this will give us 3x minus 4. And if you have been doing everything right, and for all the other questions you will be using this procedure, remember that this term inside and this term inside must always be the same. This must be, so this is, remember that both of these must be same. If they are not same, it means that somewhere we haven't done everything right. But because in this case they are same, so we are going to take that as a common, and we will write 3x minus 4. We'll take this common and write inside this 3x and plus 2. So we will write 3x plus 2, and we see that their product is still equal to 0, which is only possible if 3x minus 4 is equal to 0. So either 3x minus 4 is equal to 0, or 3x plus 2 is equal to 0. And sure enough, this quadratic equation has been reduced now to the problem of solving two linear equations, 3x minus 4 equal to 0. And for solving this, we always know what we need to do. We are going to isolate x on one side, and for that purpose, we will transfer this minus 4 from here to the other side by adding 4 on both sides. So this will give us 3x equal to 4, and we will divide 3 on both sides. This will give us x equal to 4 over 3. And similarly, if we do the procedure for the other one, or we have 3x equal to minus 2, and then we do is divide, and this will give us x equal to minus 2 over 3. So the solution set will be is equal to 4 over 3 and minus 2 over 3. If we want to verify this solution, we can do the verification process as well. Verification. And for verification, what was the equation? Equation was 9x square minus 6x minus 8 is equal to 0. So let's check the value at x equal to minus 2 over 3. At x equal to minus 2 over 3, this is left-hand side. Left-hand side we will expand, and that is 9 times minus 2 over 3 square minus 6 times minus 2 over 3 minus 8. So if we simplify, this would give us 9 times 4 over 9. Minus time minus will become plus, and this will give us 2 times 6, so this will become plus 4 here, and then minus 8 here. So 9 will cancel with 9, and this will give us 4 plus 4 minus 8, and this gives us 0, which is equal to right hand side. So this solution is verified. Similarly, if we want to verify the other part of the solution, at x is equal to 4 over 3, if we want to verify this part as well, we can do the verification for left hand side. Left hand side, this would be 9x squared minus 6x minus 8. Let's draw the line to separate the two. So this would be equal to 9 times, what would be 4 over 3. So this would be 4 over 3 square minus 6 times 4 over 3 minus 8. And then if we do the simplification, 9 times 16 over 9 minus same 3, 2 times is 6. So 2 times is this 8 minus 8, and then this is 16 minus 16, because 9 will cancel with 9, and this will be equal to 0, and this is equal to right hand side. See, for both of these values of x, the equation is satisfied. Therefore, we found the solution by using factorization.